We're on the side of the street. We're heading to go swim with the dolphins. And there's these street vendors selling fruits and sugarcane and coconuts and certain things. It's very green here, very rich. Sugarcane, we have coconuts. Coconuts, man. I think these are oranges, man. Some banana, man.
Apple, man.
Bananas.
Coconuts.
Over there, man. I think this is a fruit, man.
What kind of fruit is it, man?
I don't know. Hello, man.
Hello, man.
Do you have cane?
Let's see. You want to peel now? You want to peel now?
Which one?
You want to peel now?
Oh, the peel now. I'm not sure. Let me ask my friend if he wants some. 1 minute. I guess you don't want to upset that man. All right, so I'm gonna get
a serious thing, man. Huh?
Yeah, man.
Go down the road, man. I don't know why I'm making that problem to you.
So she has said she can't understand Jamaican people. And this is the most insane thing. Because when she said it, you know, it's like, me see that happen already, you know. Me see it already. That's, so me can't even share the pain which she have in her. And me can't also share the whole thing. Angela said she don't understand Jamaican people. Because they must sell near a sign mark. No vending. And the people them hang up the clothes by the sign of them sell. It's amazing. The people them hang up the clothes. The things them with them sell, them hang it up on the sign where say no vending. So you know, say, Jamaican mindset. Stay away. I don't know how we're going to change that mindset. But you see now, when you go there and tell them to take off that off. I can't stop saying it. I have to say it. I keep saying it. And it might sound like me I defend certain thing, but it's a certain principle. I can't understand how them people they do it, and the government can't do it. Me say, Zeke's, when Zeke's that control Matches Lane, Princess Street, and all the surrounding areas, them. Me say, Zeke, do something up to now when me not see the government at all. Right from Princess Street there, from West Queen Street, go right down. Zeke's tell the people them say, no vending, no vending. They put up the sign them, no vending. And me I tell you say, nobody broke the law there when Zeke's there. Zeke said, no vending, no vending. You know, see, nobody have vending there. Zeke's not there. Vending more than vending there. And the people them put them thing in the old tarpaulin, in the blue tarpaulin them, spread it out almost in the middle of the road. Not to mention the sidewalk. And when they spread it up on the sidewalk now, you don't know if you walk, you know. And you walk, that's you know really going at the middle of the road. Them start to cuss you. And I tell you, so where you want to step on them things for? But you are now. All these man with them called criminal. Get the people them to obey a sign, remark, no vending. And now the people them see the sign, mark, no vending. I hang up them Chinese clothes, them Chinese wear, pan the sign, remark, no vending. Some of them even go far enough. It's a weird thing, you know. Them stretch card from one sign to the... Them stretch card from one side to the next side, you know, hang up them clothes with them and sell pan the sign, make line from one sign to the next sign. I hang up them clothes pan it. the other man them now for make the thing come away, you know, them put them things on the top of all in. And when them hear the police, it's like a telephone thing, you know. It's like one of them Chinese telephone, you know, man, the police are coming. I hear man say, hey, police are coming, and I say, police. Over the tarpaulin, pan the whole things them, and lift up the tarpaulin and gone. Well, it look like they never say. You see, when them hear the police gone, them come back at the same spot, block up the sidewalk, block up the road, sit down in front of people's store who are paying rent for them store, and don't realize about wait. The man who in the store appear rent for him store, or you come block up the man, do away. Not even that consideration that some of them give the people them in a rasta. And then them say you have fight against poor people and fight you lick out food out of their mouth. But you know it's the government for fault, you know. The government for fault because them thing that could have done happen, you know. Because them have law to govern them thing. But you see all the government stay, you know. Them wait till the people them all build all hey, people all upon sidewalk, you know. I mean, sidewalk. And the people, them realize that nothing happened when them started a little touch-up thing with a little tarpaulin. And then them say, you know, say if we get a little 20-foot put by the sidewalk. 20-foot container put by the sidewalk. It's that sidewalk, you know, Rasta. We don't understand it, you know. It's a sidewalk. Anyway, we're going to come back to it. We're going to come back to it. You know what I'm saying? The sporting choice of IRFM now brings you a live report on the 2016 stepping race over there with you. You know, so I said, holiday are come up, so you know what that mean. So it go. IRFM have to eat. No food! I love to eat some no food too, but I forgot to buy some shares in IRFM to eat the food. Anyway, here we know. We are talk about how some people know. I can tell you how this thing is going on because it's really a weird thing. And I mean, I say, I blame the government. You know why? All right. A man a walk down the road that land. Just not directly pan the sidewalk. But you know, it not depend on the sidewalk, but it have a little dirt part. So if I go pass and I say, boy, you know, say a whole heap of people pass here, so could I really set up a little thing, you know. So I'm go home and him figure it out, build up a little bamboo thing, put a tap in over it and start sell some fruits. A brother passed and I said, but wait. A fruit see myself, you know, say me say a little cigarette, a little orange juice, and everything. They get a little cooler. We could have do a thing. So him come and sit on beside the brother. And next man I pass on, I say, did. I think he can go on, so you know, me set up a little cane style and coconut. So him come now, so I treat somebody have this, you know. This is a piece of land where nobody knows supposed to sell, you know. No. You see, the first man we go there now, him say him did it so long, him and say, but you know, so me could I get a little container. This a land where the female, this a land where people, public supposed to work pan. Him go get a 20-foot container and put pan the side of the road. And instead of him now just a sell orange, you know, him start to sell box drinks, pliers, nail, hammer. And all them things there. When him gone, him said, well, you know what I'm saying? Could I really add on a little thing, a little concrete part, and put some chair outside and turn two set, turn a box outside and, you know, make some music. So I'm going, you know, and me like, me that he might go more and more upon the sidewalk, you know. He might go more and more upon the sidewalk. The little second man will go, you know, him decide, say, why, my little things look funny, you know, and he want a container too. So I'm going to buy a 20-foot container and put beside the next man with the container. It's a container mall you have right there, so no. The police have seen that. Government people have seen that, you know, and them not do nothing about it, you know. The man there for years are going and feed him picnic. Half of the little container upon the little land where he's not supposed to depend, I feed him picnic. Then all of a sudden now, them just come and say, boy, right now, he have to move because he's there illegally. You mean so nobody never see them there 5 years, 10 years, 20 years. Some man they alter and never see the thing illegal. So now you're gonna move the people them now. Where you want the people them though? You're supposed to nip the thing in the bud. You're not supposed to wait till the thing mature now. And then you want to come dig out the thing. So where you want the people them for do? In that case, because they can't get no work, them find a way for sustain themselves. But you wait till the people then put structure upon the place. We can't move again. Who is going to decide that the law and the order must be maintained? A man has said right banana upon the side of the road. Upon the sidewalk, he must sell right banana, you know. And all of a sudden, him bring out 3-4 bucks. A ripe banana come put on the side of the road. You have to walk to dodge the box. Then him friend come there now with a little shed, like where them use on beach, to hide him from the sun. So him open out the umbrella on the side of the umbrella. You can't walk on the sidewalk again, you know, because from the umbrella open on the sidewalk now, you have to go take the road feet. Because if you ever pass your bunks, you know, I'm going to say, dirty boy, where you deal with? Man, I try to eat a food, I there, move, you understand? And start a thing. So if him friend knows, he say him have a little umbrella there, so now because rain gonna fall, him bring one tarpaulin, each up two little stick in the fence, and him have a little thing, a little shell go on it, so banana them, with the pineapple them, start peeing, hey, and people see that, you know. People see that go on and do nothing about it, you know. Nothing at all, they not do about it. When they didn't nip the thing at the board, just like when we talk about Longer Matches Lane and them place there. How Zeke's and Dudus could have get the people them. I mean, watch your man. Dudus, Darling Street, Coronation Market. Me see people go down at Coronation Market. Uptown people start to go at Coronation Market. We ready for that again? Our news time, see it? I talk to Anal, watch the time, you know. Okay, a news time, you know, 2:45. News and do this a while ago, and how Zeke's creator environment on a road where up to now the government has tried to clean it and can't clean it. And even though me love Angela, me know say Angela try her best, but me I tell you, the best is not good enough. So, Darling Street, the other time when a pure chaos down at Darling Street, you know, I know if you park your car, you know, I know if you, no, what me say happen is that the man them make a car park on the right as you turn down Darling Street on the right at the market. Uptown people, you're frightened if you know it's a downtown you're there on a certain day. You're frightened if you know that because when you see the kind of car them come down there, and the kind of people that come down there. They have a car for place to park. You have a man outside the road that direct you which part you park and all that. And when you look on the road, not one single car in West Queen Street and down at which part of the police station they know. Not one car parked there. Not even a cat parked there. Nobody now block the road or nothing. How the hell these men was able to do these things? And the government have soldier with gun, them have police with gun, them have all market people. How the hell these people was able to control a situation that the government over the years has been trying to do? It's pure chaos down there, you know? Especially on Saturday morning, Friday evening, Saturday morning, pure chaos down there. Me not understand it. You look on our Beckford Street. I mean, people just not care. Them no business. A guy set up him things. There's no sidewalk again down at them place there, you know. Maybe them try to block off between. Them should have block off from West Queen Street, which part it start, West Queen Street, go right back West Street. So from West Queen Street to West Street, from Beckford Street, go right down to Barry Street. And maybe try to block it off and make it be an area. But then again, it's a problem that, you know, because it's going to look like the market itself. And the more the sufferation reach the people them, is the more them try to find a way out. And most of the time when them try to find a way out, them start to inconvenience others. And that is the problem with it, you know. When you don't have order in a society, the people them who get disorderly start to really infringe upon the next person. It's like a man in our area a play music. And they play the music loud. And when you look in at the dance, them there, it's all the make the nice party set. And about five other people sit down there and drink. And them turn up the music loud, 1, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock in the morning. And if you go there now, call police upon them now to turn on the music. Them say the police and the government are fight against poor people, and them are fight against the music. But why the hell you would have want to play the music so loud? And nobody knowing the special dance. And not wrong with that, sometimes it's not even the music. A whole heap of people, well, me not say everybody still, but it's not. Sometimes I know the music, the people, them contend with, you know. It's the man we attack for the sound system. Because you could have hear the music is one thing, but when a man there, they are trout and throat out like say, I have cancer and I'm throat. I tell fire links, I'm going to have cancer and I'm throat, and they don't believe me, you know. When a man there, and a ball out loud, 1, 2 o'clock, a man, you don't want to hear that. You don't want to hear that in your bed, Rasta. And then you hear a man say, I fight against the music, and I please have some, don't inconvenience somebody trying to make yourself, your happiness must not infringe upon the next man's convenience. Because that's not happiness, that is selfishness. Selfishness. When you ever choose something upon the road, and a man ever say, Bridget, you know, you throw that upon the road. You know, see, I don't chop the road. Hear the man answer now. But if him not throw it upon the road, the garbage man not have no work. It's some crazy talk that, you know. Crazy talk that. If him not throw it upon the road, the garbage man not have no work, you know. That is the level of thinking. Now the people them saturate the roadside with all sorts of building and put up. Me say, man, I'll have nightclub on sidewalk. You know. Believe you me, you know. Me pass some place, you know, me, I say, but wait. And when the nightclub go up, they come to some paper and pure nice. I go out, when me look, me say, man, sit down outside and drink rum and liquor and listen to Vibes Cartel and all them something there. But the sidewalk, you know. Sidewalk. It's amazing. It's really amazing. We are waiting for the catch part. You know, it's the catch part. The special part draw is up next, so meanwhile we are waiting for it. We could go back to this show there. Yeah, that was your 3 p.m. special part draw. Congratulations to all of today's winners. Tune in late at 5 p.m. for another chance to win in top draw dollars. Pick 2, pick 3, pick 4, and catch part draws. This is the stepping razor, the art. I say that we have a conditioning where we need to come out of it, you know, because you can't have good governance, you can't have a stable society with people who don't respect order and who feel, say, in order for them to be happy, they must infringe on a next person's right to really comfort. Not because you want to be happy, you must make a next man feel miserable. Because that's not happiness. Happiness is when you realize that your happiness bring light and glow to the next person or the next group of people. You can't say you happy over here, so me over this, you are bald and rotted because of your happiness. No go so. No go so. When you smile, the whole world supposed to smile with you. You understand? So we need faith. Because we not stop saying, you know. How we going to stop saying? We not stop talking about the garbage in the book of the gully. We see this government here come here somewhere, you know. This government here, on the government people, you know. We want to put back the water fountain them in the main part, them which part them used today, you know. Yeah, we want to put back some water fountain. Because water is a therapeutical healing. It's a therapeutic healing. We need some water in the city. Big cities, since we're not talking about on its third, on its first world mind. First world minded people think about clean environment, lush greenness around you. With water. You have to have water, no matter how hustling and bustling the city is. You have to have some level of nature that is really helping to alleviate the hustle and the bustle that you find yourself in big city areas. We need some fountain in the city with water. The last time a fountain was in Avery, them turn it up so high that it started blow up and went up the whole of the people there on the road. But I tell you, when you drive, go down the road, you know, and you stop at the stoplight, right at the start, the Avery clock tower there. You better don't stop too long, you know, because the water blow over there by you. You have to turn up your glass like rain and fall. It's madness, that, you know. It's madness. Them used to have a water fountain. So, they make it in such a way that madman them start day the night. Me don't rag them. But me don't know how the things set that way there. We have a government just so now. How far this government going to take the environment seriously? Because when we talk about the water in the city and planting some plant, you know, in the city, we are chopped down too much tree and not plant back nothing. When we are talking about that, we are talking about something where we calm. Everything connected, you know. Everything connected. You see the concrete and steel. You can't tell me say concrete and steel not have a direct relationship with people habit and how them view themselves. Because if you live in an area where nothing can grow, it's a different mindset you have. If you live in an area where nothing can grow, just pure concrete around you. Nobody can tell me no different. That is the law of nature. If no nature, if no natural thing around you, your mindset is totally different. So if you live in a city, all right, look at even New York. You go to New York, in a people place, on top of them building. When you go on top of them building and look, you see a garden up there. You can't believe it's in the middle of the city. We up on top of the large floor. Man have garden up there. With all things, some plant and bird and all them, something there in a cage and all them, so you say, wow. Why would I never believe say, all these things that the Migla Manhattan? Central Park is a main place for people. Sometimes the water in a Emancipation Park flow, and sometimes it no flow. You need a whole heap of these things in the city. And it help, not care where you are, say, it help. These things help. It help to soothe the human nature. It help. Concrete and steel harden you. If you don't have no dirt around you, you could have talked like more. That's why you see the more they build these high-rise buildings, with more people stuck on top of one another, the people them get cold, man. May I tell you? The people them get cold. You see the environment where you have greenery, lushness, water, is a total different vibration surround you. We don't understand that because nobody never actually tell you that. The art of placement, the art of understanding, fresh air, river, you know. I mean, old-time people used to know that. Old-time people used to know what it is to go to the river, to plant a fruit tree, eat from your own fruit tree, from your own vineyard. It gives you a sense of, it's a healing, and we lose that, you know, the concrete and steel. Yet still, even within the concrete and steel, we can develop a natural habit and a nature habit if we just use our natural instinct to come closer with nature. And the government have to help. Them have to help. So we know, say, you have people, even though they have no environmental ministry, because the last brother, they know, him take the sand from over there, so put over there and say, the moving of the sun outweigh any other thing. Outweigh any other environmental thing we don't want to talk about. We hope that these little people are now don't fall for that. That even though we have bill and we can't stop progress, construction is very important. And we understand construction because construction brings a whole heap of job to people. But within the construction, we can't disregard nature. We can't just build concrete structures so in the concrete structure, you know, have little plant and fruit tree and, you know, them where they just have the thing, you know. That's why they have park. Jamaica, Hope Yard is one of the nicest botanical gardens. The other day, they are gone and them say the show are keeping a botanical garden. And I say, wicked, I will go up there. It's a nice botanical garden. But me I tell the Bridget, say, boy, me I tell the truth. You want to see Hope Garden in a little island called Botanical Garden. And Botanical Garden is a place where people can go, relax, and meditate, and just have a different perspective. Different perspective. After the hustle and bustle of King Street and West King Street and everything, you want something else, brethren. You want something else. That's why a man can chew all them nastiness out of bus. And not feel no way. Him not feel no way about it. So I don't know where these people can do for the people in Jamaica. Because we would have tackled the environment right away, you know. We would have tackled that right away. All the nastiness clean up. I talk about not only the nastiness in your mind, but I talk about the nastiness on the road, in the gully them, in the river. Because if you don't do that, you could have talked about progress a little more, you know. You could have talked about progress a little more. The same man, most of them man, they live in an area where they have no, not when they have tree, you know. Them run left on and gone, go among some tree, you know. And carry the gun with the tree, carry the gun which by the tree there, you know. Wooly a man who used to run left town now and gone all a Montego Bay. And in the bush part of Montego Bay I'm living now. And in some ghetto area. And you hear the Bridget say, most gunman poor, you know. And that's true, my talk, you know. Most gunman poor. But we need some guidance. We need some guidance. You have to have some guidance because the people them blind. And in the kingdom of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. What me say? In the kingdom of the blind, the one-eyed man is king. You know, say, it's through the language. Sometimes people get turned off of the music through the language. You know, say, old people, you have some people who are stuck in a 60s and 70s music, and they don't want to listen to nothing where the youth them are make. And you have some youth now, you can't play nothing. You can't play all the Bob Marley music at certain party. They're vexed. You know, seriously, you play some Bob Marley, say, tell me something, Muta, you can't play some reggae. I tell this is what I play. I feel like it's a reggae where you talk about. I know exactly what I talk about, the dance and music I talk about, but it's very interesting that you hear some music. Like how me sit down and listen to it now. Me sit down and listen. The tune you can't play, though. Not for the dancing of it, but just for knowing, say, in the old cobweb, you have some conscious political statement that is made that is necessary for to be heard. You understand? So, this government run by the Jamaica Labour Party is guilty of the most atrocities that has ever been done to Jamaican people. We not stop saying that. That is true. Especially the Rastafari community. This government, Jamaica Labour Party government, from in the 50s, and really reached its head 1 year, less than 1 year after them say, them 3 was the time when the Coral Garden massacre took place and the Rastafari community. This atrocity gave way for the mandatory sentence of 18 months for the possession of ganja. This was because of that same time, because you know them say, anybody who smoke ganja, mad people. It's a terrible thing. Well, over the years, we have been doing the Coral Garden, what them call it, commemoration in Montego Bay. You have some people that say, well, everything, every year are the same thing, are the same thing. But guess what now? You see agitation and you see perseverance. Agitation and perseverance is a key thing in a way you call now. Overcoming. And we see last year, the public defender gathered up information and has now presented to the Parliament of Jamaica. Well, the government changed. So we want to see, which is, this is the right government to deal with it, you know. The Jamaica Labour Party government is the right government to deal with it because it happened under Fidem leader. And now one of the national heroes of Jamaica, Sir Bustamante. From in the 50s when him go and mash down Pinnacle. Tear down Pinnacle. And cause Rasta for this person all over the place, including down a place named Bakawal. We have said that commemoration has been going on for years. And Rastafari has never resisted from reminding the people that these things take place against the citizens of Jamaica. And we must have an apology from the government of Jamaica, not individual members of the government who never serve under the government, because we know that Mike Henry coming down to one of the commemorations apologize as an individual person. Well, we hope that Mike Henry still feel the same way. Well, we now feel same change still. We know say him a fight for reparation. And it was one of them who did talk about how you cannot recognize Bob Marley and then make something that him use illegal when it's a sacrament to Rasta. He has been very outspoken about that. But well, Mike Henry is now part of the government that has created that atrocity and Rastafari in 1963, and the thing that them call Bad Friday, which is next week Friday, them call it Bad Friday, we call it Bad Friday, them call it Good Friday. And as usual, the commemoration continue, because it not stop. Because we still are waiting upon the outcome of the public defenders paper that them give to the government to find out what is that exactly them going to say. But the apology is the first thing. The apology is the first thing. We are calling upon the minister that is now the prime minister. What me say? Right there, Tony. Yeah. Andrew Wallace is 50. He might not 50. He might 40 still, right? Eh? He might 40. All right. He might early 40s. Yeah. You serious? A life I take him, man. He might look old, man. If look old Rasta, if I turn Obama, probably Obama, when Obama did first go to power, Rasta, the man look like, yeah, a face boy. You know, we call face boy in Jamaica. Now the man look away, but we're calling upon the Prime Minister of Jamaica, Andrew Michael Holness, to recognize that it was the Jamaica Labour Party government under the leadership of Bustamante, atrocity upon the Rastafari community. And the Rastafari community is the community that has placed Jamaica on the map. And if we want to talk about Bob Marley, we can talk about Bob Marley, because if it wasn't for Rastafari, there would be no Bob Marley. So we have to really go to the root and say, give thanks to Rastafari that was able to shape and sanctify Bob Marley, that him could go out there and put Jamaica upon the map. Rastafari has given the world what them want to call a new cultural expression in relationship to what them would want to call a religion. Rastafari has been able to shape and guide them Africanness more than anything else. The cultural expression of Rastafari has spread wide and far, near and top and bottom. We want to say Rastafari, undoubtedly, without any dispute, has made Jamaica into a cultural mecca. Rastafari, the culture of Rastafari, has enabled Jamaica to be a cultural mecca. So we now beg no one for no respect. Rastafari, respect is due, and respect is given, is due, and respect must be given. This is not the days now when we are going to walk on the road and attack this and attack that. It's respect we are dealing with. You don't have to believe the logical aspect of Rastafari. You don't even have to be and look like a Rastafari. But given that Rastafari has been able to maintain and still be a vanguard in what we now call the reparation movement that has been taken up by scholars and professors and doctors of the universities and head of state and government in the Caribbean, it was Rastafari who was shouting for reparation. So, it's not some lazy people who sit down and just smoke ganja, even though that is the expression that was there and is still there, that we must go this and that and do all sorts of things. And your people are talking about, but Rasta no have no university, Rasta no have no hospital, Rasta no have no school. Look here, man. Not having no university and having no school does not define Rasta's movement, the ability to awaken the African people. We are told by one of the scholars of the university, who dead now, him say, Rastafari is the memory of the Jamaican people. Rastafari is the memory of the Jamaican people. And when everybody seems to want to forget them Africanness, it is the Rastafari brethren and sisters that is reminding the Jamaican people that, look here, man, don't cut off your umbilical cord. According to Winnie Mandela, the Jamaican people umbilical cord connected to Africa. So, we might be chanting and keeping these things every year, and people might say, what purpose it serves? We say, I think it was 2013, when IRFM took this march and rally on the road for the recognition of the Coral Garden massacre. And we did start from World Theatre and move up to Racecourse and then move up to Mandela Park. It was one of the biggest rallies anybody has ever seen. We are saying that the race is not for the swift. Them say not the battle is not for the strong, but it's who can endure to the end. And we now go on like say, why Rasta, why you not say this and I say that, me not see nothing happen. Well, me know say something happen, because if me never know say something happen, would have gone somewhere else. But it's not the turtle people look upon, you know, is the rabbit. But true, the rabbit move fast. The rabbit say, "Chow, the turkey now go catch me up, you know. I'm going to drop asleep." And him drop asleep by the wayside. And the turkey crawl and crawl and crawl and win the race. Rastafari can be likened to the turkey that will go through all of this tribulation and trials for years. For years. But we persevere and we stand tall. And we want to say to my brethren them, Rastafari, brethren and sister them, don't make the thing get you giddy and get you twisted, you know. Because there's a light at the end of the tunnel you don't want, because you don't see the light, that's all yourself trying to light on the end, you know. We know, we not ask somebody that. African people must find them place in the scheme of things again. Racial is not a little, because we are keep it, and we are called upon the Prime Minister of Jamaica, you know, Andrew Holness, to recognize, if him don't even know about it, you know, because we hear him is 40 at the world. It's 53 years ago this thing happened, before him born. We want you to examine carefully the report from the public, the public defender office. We want you to examine it carefully, you know. And examine the Rastafari community as it is today. And all the things them that Rastafari has done to elevate Jamaica. And know, say, just like your friend, without a governmental button touch upon him, where Junior Manning used to call a plainclothes Rasta. We are talking about Mike Henry. Mike Henry attack and he up all Rastafari, right? You know, I just last year, you know, me hear him already longer, forever young. When me hear, me say, me close my eye with that thing, says a Rasta attack upon the stage. When me hear Mike Henry attack, forever young, the other day when we celebrate the Paul Bogle thing, big thing going on a five year and him come down the attack. If you close your eye, that thing says a Rasta attack. Junior Manning, who spearheaded this commemoration over the years and him passed now. We didn't know, say, this is not going to happen where some form of justification for our shouting and bawling out must be heard by someone who's in authority that can take it up and carried further. So, on the 25th of March, the struggle continued at Jared Park. It is the 50th celebration of Bad Friday Carroll Gardens atrocities, 1963. On the 25th of March, 2016, in Montego Bay, this will be taking place again, and we will be there again. Last year I couldn't go there because we did Africa. Ironically, we'll go back to Africa again, but it's so happened now that Easter fall in March this year and not in April. So we are saying we want to see the people them. We want to see the rest of them. The rest of them can't just jump up and down the place and stay through every day and don't really take part in something that is relating to the history of Rastafari. Bad Friday is one of them history that we will never forget. Never forget it. So, we just remind the people them that next week, for the 25th, 2016 at Jared Park is the commemoration of the 53rd and the 53rd commemoration of Bad Friday. This happened 53 years ago, months after Jamaica got independence and 3 years after Haile Selassie came to Jamaica. When that atrocity was in its heights, Haile Selassie came to Jamaica, that we could have seen at present moment is the only king will go in a king's house. And that was the only time Rastafari was free to go into king's house. Believe you me, what a day that was, 1966, when Rastafari got up and go in a king's house. It's after the first, King of Kings, conquering Lion of Judah, elect of God, light of the world. Don't feel says Rasta said them title there, you know. Those titles was given to him on his coronation, the 2nd of November 1930. It's not Rasta make up them thing there. Them thing there is Ethiopian. So, we just tell the people them that. And we're going to see what this government will do. We're going to see how far this government is going to stretch this thing. Because the woman do her work and she make certain findings. She put it in her paper and she send it to the parliament. We don't want them put that underneath no ground, you know. We hear them ask about FinSAC again, you know. This government ask about FinSAC because the other one did I say too much expense are going on. Well, we see them want them a drawback for the FinSAC thing. I don't want them to forget, say, you have a big issue on the board with this government. Just like all them a draw for FinSAC now, you know. I don't want them to forget, say, this government was involved in a next atrocity that took place on the people of Tivoli Garden. We don't want them to forget that, you know. And them call a man from Barbados to look about it. And them say, we don't hear the findings yet, but we are hoping that the findings will come soon and that it will be in favor of the people of Tivoli Garden who that atrocity was done to. We can't have atrocities on top of atrocities. And then nothing happen. No compensation. No apology. Nothing. And it always fall upon this Jamaica Labour Party government. So we are saying, we know say you have people inside there who figure out the thing and know say certain things not right. And we see some new people come in there whenever every band. When my daughter is born, much less. But now them know a whole lamp on the rain of power in a Jamaica. And it cannot be. It cannot be that things will take place that has caused much grief to the Jamaican populace. It's just thrown under the carpet, waiting for a next grievous thing to happen. Because we don't want to say that here this government come again, because here this government did say anytime the PNP in a power, crime rate increase. Well, we don't know what kind of formula them have, but we hope that they will bear fruit, that the people will really say, but maybe you know say true, when the PNP in a government, you know, the crime really escalating, but look how the crime gone down now. And that's why the people that we want the crime rate go to pre-independence. And that's how we want the crime rate go pre-independence. So me don't know how they're gonna do it, but it is necessary and important because me remember New York City. Me remember New York City. And a guy and the mayor come there. Mayor Gelani come there. But New York is no more a feared town, a feared city. And we tell Peter Bunting, we talk to Peter Bunting through this program already. And we say, maybe we need to go find out what those people do and see if you can think that them do to alleviate the crime problem in Jamaica. Speaking of which, last week we was talking about the music hall, that we really feel it necessary and important that this government now should have turned it eye upon so we can accommodate one of the things that has given Jamaica a cultural mecca status in the world. UNESCO Carl Kingston cultural, I mean, it's a big thing. Anyway, I am really glad that Babsy Grange was listening to the program last week when she heard me talk and call her name, say, Babsy, I don't want to go to the China people, them, you know. But it can't come like everything we want to build in Jamaica now if we turn to China. Well, I'm so happy that she was listening, that when I was driving home, we had a long talk. And it's just junction while my phone lock up, but I lock talk and I'm planning to have more talk. So, Babsy, I hope you're listening again, or any one of your people them there listening, and I really appreciate that you were listening and you really respond to what I was saying. Really. So even though sometimes I might feel some them have people who are listening and tell them, why you're mother talk about on the radio, why I'm cussing the same cuss, must talk about the good things that we are talking about. They must talk about how we are talking about we want some water fountain in the city and some plant and stop cutting down so much of the tree them in the city. Too much concrete and steel make the people them hard. Hard when they use the concrete and steel. She come out, she get hard now. Anyway, what does I say? That is very important. Very important. We now stop talk, even though people are saying, boy, the talking, talking. Well, talking is good. I do have nothing against them. Even the dumb and ignorant have story, you know. So when I go around the world, they never go fight, shoot nobody, you know. Them talk and sign paper and make people go kill one. I have nothing against sitting down and talk. Because out of that talking, you will be able, best able to construct your way forward. Everything that is done was started from speaking. And we do have nothing against that. We have a microphone in our way, in front of it. We speak. This is the razor, the art of war. Yes, Ill.
Hello.
Yeah, blessing.
What, well, man? Christmas are here again, you know. Hello.
Yeah, man. Me are here, man.
Why, you know, I send condolence to my uncle passed off last week, you know.
Okay.
Yeah, man. Me always call him Muta, you know. My uncle did, you know.
All right, sir.
I really feel it, man. I mean, I talk about, I mean, I want to leave a California, I want to say happy birthday to her today, her birthday, so big up Pamela, you know, respect, you know.
All right, thank you. Yeah.
Pamela, you know.
Yeah.
Respect.
All right.
So, you know, tell me, say, we want to have...
Easter.
You mean I talk to you, I mean, I tell you, say, what Easter mean, you know.
When may I talk about Easter?
You know, I say, you know, talk, if, when I talk to you, you know, tell me, say, you easy talk about Easter will come up, you know.
All right. So, what you want to talk about Easter now?
So,
talk about it quick.
More you find, yeah, the Bible can find Psalms 8 verse 4.
Where Psalms 8 verse 4? So, just tell me, man. Me will believe you.
Oh, yeah. If the last word of Jesus, where Jesus said before then came.
Hold on there. Jesus known as the Psalms, brethren. Oh, you're going to ask Jesus.
No,
Psalms,
man. Listen to me, after, man. The last thing where man said before then kill him, verse 4. You know, we mindful of no man. You see me, I say, and no man him do so, a woman him lie with so, and then kill him.
Yo, don't twist up the thing, you know.
Which then we part, Psalms 4, least verse 4, no man.
Wait, no man. You don't have to say, me read Psalms 4. I'm going to tell you, say, read it. Listen to you now, listen to me.
Now listen.
You just tell me, say, must read Psalms 4. And then
no, Psalms 8, man.
All right, you tell me must read Psalms 8. And when me start,
yes,
to tell you...
Verse 4.
How about this, brother, you Rasta? Yeah, listen to me, you listen to me.
Yeah, me listen, man.
All right, you tell me must read Psalms 8, verse 4. And when me ask you, where it say, you start to tell me about what Jesus said when before him dead.
No, me, I say the last thing what Jesus said before him hanging.
Where him say? Where him say before him hanging?
They read that, you know, find the funeral, man, or somebody.
Appear he dead in the studio. Nobody know no Bible inside us. So you tell me where it say.
It's a old man to remind full of. You hear me, I say? You understand?
That's the last.
Before them kill him, that him say, because if you them kill him, just to them say, because so, woman him lie with, but the animal say, and a man him lie with, so he must say, old man to remind full of.
And where you get them fool? Where you get them foolishness from? So what Psalms 8 say? What Psalms 8 say?
Your name is so excellent in the alley from the top to the bottom. Kill a baby no motor.
What Psalms 8 verse 4 say?
It say, who is man to remind, who is mindful of? You know, read him and find somebody, you know, by the Bible.
So, how you interpret that? Who is man that
I interpret it? I last thing with Jesus said before then kill him.
What do you interpret him to mean? When him say that, what do you interpret him to mean? What do you think he mean when him say that?
That means, say, when him kill him, for two of them say, like, that woman a wrong way, but him say, a man take up upon the med, say, a man thing. So,
all right, you're not the virgin. Which part you call from?
So, you're not about Easter.
No, where you call from?
Iron's Mountain.
Which part Iron's Mountain there?
When you come Balatal and come up
Balatal, right. Any Rasta man round that area there?
Rasta man, yeah man.
Alright, you want me to ask you for you now. Go find a Rasta man, you see, and buy a nice spliff from him. And sit down and smoke the spliff and get your head together. Hear? Yeah? Alright, alright. Yes, so. The first call, that's why I say, afraid for what the call, afraid for what the phone, you know, believe me. Afraid for what the phone, believe you, be afraid for what the phone. All right. We can go back to the YouTube. Chow, me play the YouTube, you know, all right, me enjoy the tune. Chow, all right. All right, go, please, please, in the name of Tony and Neil, please don't make a next one of them calling up on the line. I'm going to push up the button now, all right, here goes. Hello?
Muta, you hear me?
Oh, gosh, my brain's... Yes, yes, yeah, me, I hear you.
Muta.
Yes, sir.
You hear me now?
Yeah, man, me, I hear you, man.
Hey, we like the train, no, Muta, but it takes too long for taking the call, man.
Yeah, you know why?
Why?
Because of the brother were before me. I them kind of call.
No, man, before, at 4 o'clock, you start taking the call. Why you have to take in the call so late, brethren?
I can't do taking no call at all, too.
Yeah, but you both taking the call earlier than that, brethren.
Yeah, you know, I tell you what
to do. You're not but taking the call too late.
But I could have don't take in no call too. Anyway, where you talk about?
And if you're alone,
program, all right, you call because me?
We not cross you, but me, I tell you, man, take in the call early and listen, man.
All right, sir. All right,
and you
sir.
Want one talking about Virgin?
All right, sir. So that you want call, you call me to tell me that. I must take in the call earlier. All right, give thanks. Give thanks.
Yeah, man, love.
Yeah. All right. I'm afraid to push up the phone. I'm afraid to push up the thing. I some money kids coming here trying to smile to write it. Believe you me. All right, but I go and play this future. I love that tune. Have you been done? Yeah? All right, the next man cut out my tune again. Yeah.
Highly high.
Blessed man.
Highly high. What's up, Aya? Step in razor.
Talk
with the music. Go on, Muta.
Wait, the holy patin can't talk about until the music news done, you know. So you have to go call me back.
Highly high. Blessed love. I just have you from St. Thomas.
I know you, man. I know you.
So, I will show you back. See?
Yeah, all right. Call me back, yeah?
Highly high, me, I dream.
Yeah. When the price gone up, told you know. I tell you, she overweight now, you know. Overweight, yeah, man. She work on top of her, you know. Believe you, V. You join the elite of IRFM. You must remember where you're coming from. Yeah, this is the stepping razor. As we say, we are taking a call, in between the call, we play some music. Orthodox Isa Char, 12 Tribe Region, you know. Been to and fro in Ethiopia. Brand new music. After that, Christ a child. Coming through. Credit loan. Yes, EL.
Yes, EL Muta.
Blessed man.
Yeah, man. Blessed love, man. You want me no Muta? I'm going to chop it shot. Yeah, all right. I call from up my southwest center. A community called Caledonia.
Mm-hmm.
Where... back in that last year, we kind of did feature up on the TV about the Coptic country.
Yeah, man, may I hear you?
Yeah, man. Yeah. In the last year, referring to the Coptic country issue. Well, I was one of the person who kind of did appear up on the TV there still and get a talk call to. In a July, man, last year, July.
Yeah, so what you say? I mean, you tell me who you is, so what happened? Why you tell me that?
You know, well, right now, the people them come back, you know, and both for mine again, and I screechy, them screeching the equipment overnight on the people, man. For real.
Well, let me ask you a question. I don't make it like them breed machine, eh?
You miggle night motor.
You're serious?
See, listen, we're not like, I'm
no,
a
never say you lie.
I'm not lighting, you know.
Me never say you lie. Me ask them, you're serious, me never say you lie.
Serious. Serious, man.
So when them start mine the same place to them the day all while?
No, they moved to the next section of the community, I know now. So it's like them come behind my house, my little cabin where me live, I know now.
Mm.
To come dig, you know. But what the trick is that them come, them all dig the front part of the thing, so them come with some little paper for the people and for sign.
Okay.
So them tell about the front part, but them not tell us that them all screeching at the back door.
All right, so what are we going to do about it?
Well, right now, me and us are called for just in case, like the minister,
like
Mr. Henry, and even Mr. the PRO man out of Kaiser, they are here. So we are going to stop the work, you know.
You're going to stop the work?
Yeah, we'll stop the work. And all right, now the people are militant, you know.
All right.
I mean, real militant. And the thing is, I want. All right, to the extreme, if I saw be the case, you know what I mean? We wish we won't have to come to that, but it's not like people, everybody's stupid no more.
Yeah.
For real.
Well,
I just got higher, because them treat them people in them area, them take
terrible,
people,
terrible,
them take
terrible.
People fool.
So who are the mining? Who are the mining?
Where the whole of them left the people?
Where the company where mine the place? What them name?
Miranda man.
Okay.
Yeah, but what them do? Them contract out the work to private contractor.
Okay.
And they trick coming out, you know.
Sneaky.
You understand?
Yeah.
So right now, what them do now? When them want to swoop out the little backside out of area like this, yeah. Them bring in three different contractors.
Okay.
And yeah, so, and everybody so, come in well, one night and when they wake up.
We have a new minister now, so maybe you can talk to him. What do you say?
Yeah, well, we
No, Mike Henry, the mining minister. No, Mike
Henry. Yeah, no, I would like to seek audience with him, you know. So,
yeah,
like, we know so them listen to your program.
No, but you can't make audience.
No, man. We're going to put it in the written, man. We're going to do the written form of the thing, man.
All right. Yeah.
We're going about the thing the right way, man, because we don't know everything is step, you know. You have step one, step two,
yeah.
And the rest are steps. So we got to, you know what I mean, but we just decide for those girls, because we'll make them know we'll start the work tomorrow.
All right, sometimes the wrong way or the right way, too, you know. Anyway, we're gone, yeah?
All right, blessed,
yeah,
love,
man.
Mota.
Give thanks to really tell me that I go on, yeah. The man said them screeching at the middle of the night. The man said them screeching at the middle of the night. All right. We'll go back to Orthodox Isa Char. Who responds to the sign?
Yeah, on the road there, because...
I guess the Chinese then put it up there, I don't know.
You know, some of the next program the other day, I'm here, a big man, I don't call him name, where he wrote a program, I say, him travel on the highway and say, two signs to come out of angels there, but they mark A-N-G-L-E-S, and he say, two
angle.
Of them mark that.
Angle.
And then he say, come down to the next sign, and say, no, stop it, and it mark S-T-O-P-I-N-G. Them say, man, really, I wonder.
So, wait, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
When him see mark S-T-O, him never stop in. Him never stop it then.
You don't know if him stop, when say that him see.
Angle height, something wrong with it, yes.
Yeah, two players, him say two players from there, signs. Wait, come on, Mark. And he knows he doesn't matter, but Mark, A-N-G.
Yeah, maybe the Chinese one I try to talk Jamaican, I don't know.
Yeah, at that moment, I still come here, I say, oh, a mistake like that to make. I thought I'm from scratch to the head, and reach out, then I clear, we don't know.
And it's still there, how long ago you hear the man say it?
3 or 4 years there, and I'm
going to well, now that you mention it again, we're asking relevant authorities to examine the spelling.
Yeah.
Angel, I said, so you talk about Angel.
Angel,
you there. Angel, you there.
Yeah.
And stopping it, spell S-T-O-P-I-N-G.
Yeah, that's what I see.
All right, sir. So we're asking people, the relevant authorities, to look into that. Because
really?
You don't want nobody miss.
One more point before me.
Really, you don't want nobody miss the place. And when they look for Angel, like them, I look for Angle, and one that's a different place.
And it's a different angle, them say.
Yeah.
Yeah, one more about the brother last night where they still has the thing.
Which brother still has the thing?
Where them I go up a Mike and them I go up a JC.
Oh, yeah. They,
and I said one some of them can talk to. And I said Jerry Small, the JC and Bruce Golden. At that year there, you know, 1966.
Bruce Golden
was the head boy.
Yeah, that the Bridging said Bruce Golden was the head boy.
Yeah, and Dr. Peter Phillips was the in line to get the head boy to the same time. And you have Lambert Brown got a 1965 in the second from 66 when Slash come.
So Bruce Golden never did it when Haile Selassie come?
Yeah, man, 1966 was
well,
the boy,
him,
man.
Him, Ivy say we should have really try get...
The
function up there, either the university or JC, for really talk about him experience when Haile Selassie as an Edward.
Yeah, man, you can get to Bruce one. I mean, I don't know if Peter Fleece them the member Lambert Brown, because them be dead, too.
No, Peter Phillips look like him won't forget all them Rasta pass, you know. You know, see, him totally. No, Peter Phillips look like him won't amnesia about what he used to say and what he used to do. You know, see.
Easy,
yeah, man.
You know,
I don't know lie. He used to sleep on Peter Phillips' door floor, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, when 12 tribe meeting done and we can't get to go home. We go out and we sleep on Peter Mini Philip and Peter Phillips. We go out, go lay down, sleep on the floor until morning, we get up and go away yard. The man they come like them won't forget. Say
and
them,
about the Rasta fight.
Yeah, because them man they make woolly for people turn Rasta, you know.
True.
Between him and Jerry Small, where you used to try to pandle.
And
Jerry Small
are
the only one we left out of that whole heap of group. All of them things them can't go in government go change the thing and turn the system themselves. Anyway.
As you mentioned Jerry Small, yeah, I got cut him. As you mentioned Jerry
Small. Don't cut me, no. Don't know why you cut me, no, because I have too much bruise for me, and I know, believe you me.
All right. We have to tell our friend Jerry Small, say, we want to give him a shout out. He does not look a small predicament, but I'm soon. You understand?
You never seen him on the TV last night.
I know, so I never watch it for real.
Yeah, man, I'm never on the TV last night.
I lie, I'm
they got to miss their life.
Oh, all right, my boss. I don't like when we miss them on the program. The man. Yeah.
No, it wasn't the same program, you know. It was a program in Japan. All right.
Big up yourself, yeah?
Yeah, man, every time.
Ah,
yes. All right. Yeah, man, that's the worst thing with them, man, there, you know. The bridge in them, Dr. Michael Barnett, as was suggested last night, maybe we should try to get the head boy at the time when I started to come at JC. For really talk about them experience and what them did feel about Haile Selassie being there and what was the reaction and what was the whole connection. It's not good for making a talk. Yeah. Yes, Orthodox, Haile Selassie. In the groove of the African move, yes, man. We love it, Yes, yeah,
Mota.
Yeah, blessed man.
Yeah, man, you are going, you know, for a long time. I try to link you up, you know. I'm here, you always say a thing about the thinking tour, the locals.
Yeah, man, thinking tour. Good food.
Yeah, but to make me the man like this, we deal with it, but me don't know what to tell people, sir. So I want to know they like.
What do you mean, what to tell people, know. Sir? What you want to tell them? What you want to tell them about it?
The purpose of it.
Oh, you know the purpose of thinking to? All right.
Yeah.
Thinking to is a fruit where you can. All right. First of all, I can tell you where you can use it though. I can make a nice shake with it. That's the first thing. Because most of the time when I use it, a shake me make.
Yeah.
What me really do is soak it in a coconut milk.
Yes.
Like when you soak it now, it gets softer, so the seed, you don't want to really, because the seed is very big, so you don't want to put it up there. So you soak it, and then use your hand and squeeze off the fruit part of it.
Yeah, yeah.
And then now you put it in the blender with ripe banana, nutmeg, and if you want to put papaya in it, it's all right. And then you blend it, and you get a nice smoothie. It's a very, and you see the shell of it?
Yes.
I have seen craft people use the shell and make little wallet, like we put in light and all them something there. But it's a very potent food. It's a very, very potent food. And more Jamaicans should I use it. But them not like the smell of it, the pungent
smell. Of it, you know?
Yeah, but the smell, the eating of it out we are, the smell, believe you me. Because you have a salt named black salt when we use. You see that salt, you know? If you come on my yard, why Muta Baruka nasty and the man of blow wind in I'm kitchen. But It almost smells like a sulfuric thing, like rotten egg. But really, it's a better salt to use than ordinary salt because it don't heighten your blood pressure.
Okay.
Yeah, and it's not salt to a table salt like table salt. It's even better than I want to say it. Better you use that salt than even the sea salt.
The sea salt. Yeah.
But people don't like the smell of it. The smell kind of turn you off still.
Yes,
but really and truly, the same way with the stinking toe.
Yeah, yeah.
The stinking toe will turn you up. But may I tell you, it's people sometimes people are like eat it to become choke. It have a tooth powder.
Yes,
right?
Yes. It kind of so laugh when you eat it.
Yeah, it will choke you. But yeah, if you soak it in a cane juice or coconut milk,
yes,
and then you crush out the seed, put the juice, right, put the coconut juice with the sinking to a fruit.
Yeah.
In at the blender, put some ripe banana in there, put some nutmeg in there. If you use vanilla, put vanilla in there, you're gone. There. Yeah, man, it's gone. Yeah?
All right, Mota.
Yeah, blessed man, give thanks.
Yeah, man, bless it.
Yes. This is the stepping razor with still the pies at your.
Hello, Mota.
Yeah, blessed.
Mota, where are you, lady?
Where are you talking about?
Mota, imagine you're coming from I have the truth of say you alone.
That's my program.
And then you come give people, you start taking call. 4 o'clock. And then now you talk about your play music. In between, my brother. Where are you dealing with it?
No, watch out now. So, you don't know what kind of. So, wait, you tell me how to run this program, yeah? You don't know to that program, yeah? Wait now, man.
No, but I know your alone program, I
Yeah, but my program deal with music, too. Yo, my program deal with music, too. My program I just talk right through.
Yes, Mota, but you have two. I can't do the music business.
No, you can't. You can't tell me when to do the music business. With the music, I will talk. With the music, I will talk.
You know, some people have the phone and them credit are going
to move. No, them credit can't come if they not hear me. Say, take phone call. Them not call. When me ready for take the call, if not text that, it means I'm going to go and talk, I'm going to go and play the music, I'm going to go and do advertisement. It's so simple. This is not a talk show where you talk from the program start to end.
No,
you know,
don't say that.
Yeah. So is that you call me for tell me? Is that you call me for tell me? All right, tell me where you call me for tell me.
No, Mota.
When last you see my cousin? Me know your voice, you tell me don't know your voice. When last you see my cousin?
Mota, I can't find her. I don't know where she is.
You when last you go to New York? You them deport you, man. You can't go back to New York.
Mota, I can't go, Mota, but me don't. Me the Mota, the Jamaica sweet, Jamaica freedom.
All right, so where you call for talk about? Tell me quick before 5 o'clock. You have a call back. You have to call back.
That's
not me call that. And when you call. All right, blessed, yes.
Rastafari, the king of creation, liberty, Tinuali.
All right, sir.
How is everything?
Everything is everything, man. We are going
great.
Yes.
Well, this is King Yeshua, dear.
Me know how you, man. Me know how you.
Sickness and disease.
Me know how you.
Slim must overstand, sir. Without your health, it doesn't make no sense. Because sick people cannot enjoy full joy life. When you're sick and in bad health, it's caused a lot of pain and suffering, and I do not like to see people suffer and die unnecessarily from sickness and disease that can be cured easily. The medical society sit down and create up all these viruses in laboratory as new world order, population control to destroy humanity. I see people dying from cancer, people dying from herpes, syphilis, HIV, all these different diseases, when every herb is there to alkaline the blood, purify the bloodstream. No, when we are little child, you hear that as gone to them, they gave, the three wise men gave Yeshua, which is the I am that I am, frankincense, myrrh, and gold. But the gold that he was given to him is the golden seed.
Hold on there. Which part of the Bible you hear said three wise men get gold, frankincense? Which part of the Bible you hear said three wise men go visit Jesus? You never read nothing like that in the Bible.
What? So the three wise men bring us the king, frankincense,
you
and myrrh?
You never read nothing like that in the Bible about no three wise men.
Yes, man, they must say they follow the star and bring the king, frankincense, myrrh,
listen, hear what me say. Hear what me say. Listen to what me say. I'm going to make you go and talk, you know, but listen to what me say now.
Yeah.
You never hear, you never read nothing in the Bible where say three wise men go visit Yahshua. You never read that. But all right, go on.
No, they put Jesus, but the right name is Yahshua.
All right, well, Yahshua and Jesus, anyone. I say you never read nothing about no three wise men. Anyway, hold on. You, all right, you want to hold on until we go to the stadium. We'll go back to the stadium, that's what you know. All right, you want
with the organic apple cider vinegar.
Where that right? Came from? Where that
for the blood.
But wait, hold on. Every week you come with a different recipe. We do the same
you have
thing.
Several different recipe, Muta. Yeah, several, no one, man.
No, me not say no, but me not say. Give the people them a chance to digest the one them where they talk about.
First. Yeah, but some people can't get some, so what they can't get, them go out and utilize.
All right, I agree with you.
Think about the frankincense and more and the red clover blossom boiling coconut milk.
Yes.
With the organic apple cider vinegar and Epsom salt.
Yes.
That is a cure for diabetes plus HIV.
Okay.
But you boil the frankincense and more, so you use half pound or more. Quarter pound of frankincense.
Half pound of enough more than that, you know?
No, man, but I'm going to make. Because you have to make a killer virus, it takes 3 weeks to kill a virus.
Oh, so you have to take...
So you want medication, you have to take for 21 days.
Okay.
Right? So when you're killing a virus, you need 3 weeks straight.
Mm.
Right? Mm. So the olive leaf extract, the shiitake mushroom extract, and the oregano extract, the tarragon extract, and the... Which are the CBD acid. Alright?
But you know, so
and the THC.
I can sell you some frankincense and more, you know. You want some for buy?
With a grateful.
Yeah, man, I can sell you some, man.
You need to check me. I'm located at number 12 Vermont Avenue in Avondale.
Vermont Avenue, alright.
Yes. Have you come a man in the road at the gas station, turn from Bard Avenue?
No, I want to sell you some frankincense and more, but I tell
you. Yes, me buy them from you as the sake. I need them to make several medications.
Okay.
That
all
people who suffer from diabetes, you use the frankincense and more and the pink periwinkle.
So when we go to Africa again too, me can bring and make sure and know so you're gonna buy them from me.
Definitely.
Like how much pounds so you want, tell me.
Well, alright. Right now, I'm going to use, if you have around 1 5-pound or 1 10-pound.
You have 5 pound of frankincense and 5 pound of myrrh?
Yes.
You have 5 pound of frankincense and 5 pound of myrrh. All right.
Because it's very important. It's a herb that clean anything out of the bloodstream. All right? And many people will suffer from sinus. You boil the frankincense and in the same coconut milk.
All right.
Add some organic apple cider vinegar to it.
No rum this time?
No, the rum now you have to soak the frankincense and myrrh with the marijuana. But the young marijuana plant is so that in the white rum with honey and citric acid.
And mine it blow up the people. Mine, that's what like it's a bomb you make for the people.
No, that is not a bomb. That is a amino acid.
Yes.
Citric acid that build the immune system, white T cell count with the CD4 virus.
We have to move now, though.
Well, all right.
Give me the number where you live again. Give me the number.
12 Vermont Avenue.
All right. 12 Vermont Avenue. All right.
Yeah, Evendale. Yeah, and phone number 559-1303.
All right. Yes.
If you take him serious.
Then who not take him serious?
Yeah, me say...
Serious.
Yeah, me say some people out there might not take him serious, but...
Yeah.
Him good, because I have some books on him.
Is him biblical?
Yeah, when I have to pay no more, I don't deal with the disease. I don't know me needs for me and him. Coming with the program shot, so hear me and say, I know. We need to highlight him. I'm never going to make you get some local.
No, he might highlight on the program. We never lock him off yet. I'm going to let him kiss me or something, but we make him talk.
Good. He might move the local.
He do with it. So, you know, it's another way that you are using it too. So.
Yeah, things go many ways, Muta. Yeah. Things go many ways.
All right. Give thanks.
So, blessed and thanks. Yeah, Muta.
Yeah,
next time.
Yeah, give thanks, Virgin. All right.
So, I'm making get the locals and bring the locals to you.
Yeah, all right.
You know what burn me more time? Yeah? Is any man that come in like thief in the night? See when I call the hombre tell and say, them a dig down in place.
The backside people them.
Deal run up on the backside them.
Wow.
Sugar people them. They go down the water. In the river.
Oh yeah.
River.
Very.
They go to the sea. The man that kill the fish them. The man that like kill the ice them, brother.
So you go to, who you go to for report it?
Why never? Yeah, is any man coming like thief in the night? See, when I call the hombre tell and say, them a dig down in place.
The backside people, them.
Deal run up on the backside, them.
Wow.
Sugar people, them. They go down the water, in the river.
Oh, yeah.
River.
Very.
They go to the sea. The man a kill the fish, them. The man a like kill the ice, them, brother.
So you go to, who you go to for report it?
Why never people a better line, you know?
Eh? No,
so when I get no, alligator, some particular
that way you talk about, who you go to for report?
Same people.
Put it. You can't go to the people them who are doing it. Them not going to stop doing it.
What? Man, I need to run out of place with you. And the court not thing the bridge.
No, hold on, man. I ask you. You know, things you should have got to the authorities them for report the people them.
Yeah, but guess what?
What?
If you go to some people, he called upon deaf ears.
You go to them, and you go to him and mention it to him.
Yeah, man, I want to pass something. A light problem we have around there, you know.
All what?
Light. Every minute, we call GPS, we call OER to it.
No, I know the GPS thing I talk about. Are the river me I deal with, you know? Oh, the John Garner light problem. We want to rectify the dumping away you are talking about. That something must be done, and it will be to be more vigilant. How much I want to go to the minister, the counselor? How much I want to go there?
You know, there are a few hours after.
No, you know why you tell me that in the Virgin? I don't know what you want going on. You need to get up, you laugh, at you, and you know what you may attack. You need to get up a group of you know, who are concerned about it and go to the council about it.
All right.
That is what I need for
that. That going here, you know, because we have a group, Virgin.
Yeah, you have to have a group, you know. Not a one-man thing, you know. You have to have a group. Go to the root of the thing. Gather the whosoever, the woman. Gather the whosoever, the woman, the man, who concerned about it. And go have a meet with them and say, watch out, you have to put this thing as stop. Talk to the people who are doing it. Where the company name we are doing? Where the company we are dumping name?
Hey, you know, say, I'm in Tropicana, but something the response here, you know.
Mm.
Search people.
Search, all right.
Yeah, that's the man. Oh, God.
Who are you go to them?
No, we're not really so far today.
But you just tell me that you go to the people them who dumped something in there. You just tell me that a while ago.
Alright, you see, the hombre them, we make them know.
No, you want to know. Fire. You're not straight with me, you know, Bridget. You're not coming straight with me, man.
Alright, I'm not coming straight to you.
No, man, I try to help as a teacher, but you're not coming straight to me.
Alright. You're the thing, girl.
No, me don't want to hear the thing again because the time I go. When me want to tell you, if you do, get up a group of uno and go to the counselor and tell the counselor where your concern is.
All right. And if them are here.
If you go to him, the most hear what you say.
All right.
Yeah.
So you get, well, but things are
but we can't do the role of a thing right now. That specific thing me I work with. One at a time we are working. All right.
All right. Cool.
Yeah, blessed. Yeah, don't have a whole heap of things all right now. So here we are saying now, we give thanks to the moment, give thanks to the time, give thanks to Neil, and the team that right just so you know, believe you me, and the team that. You know, so next week we'll come forward with the cutting edge from 10 to 2 o'clock, cutting edge. And we just want to make you know that we are working out that broadcast that we did last year in April from the Ivory Coast. We are working to do a next right in Abidjan, so Zion Radio, the connection between Zion Radio and IRFM, cutting edge, stepping razor. We are working on it diligently to do that, because we will be there in April. So, we don't know if we can't take no more call, you know, because the thing I go. So, here we are now. I gone, you know.